your finger like this if you don't mind. So many things God has brought us out of. So many things He's brought us through. But tonight we stand before you with a new testimony. And we say, thank you.
Good evening, everybody. I hope all is well with each of you and that you have had a good week thus far. Let me say thank you to everyone that is tuning in. Like always, before we get started, I'm going to ask if you would start a watch party. Share, like, hearts, all that good stuff. But most importantly, like we say every time, be a part of our outreach and evangelism ministry. Amen. And share this, start a watch party. We want to reach out to as many people as we can. So please, ma'ams and sirs, share this so that we can be a blessing to someone else. So again, thank you all for tuning in. Let us pray. Eternal God, our Father, how we thank you for this another day's journey. God, we thank you for what you've done throughout the day, throughout the week. God, we thank you that you sat high and you looked low and you blessed us in spite of. Now, God, we pray first that you would act, that you would forgive us for all our unforgiven sins. God, that you would clean us up as you see fit, that we may be more acceptable unto you. Now, God, we pray that you bless our hearts and our minds, that we may be able to receive some word of inspiration from you, God, that we can take it and apply it to our everyday living, that we may have a closer walk with you. God, I pray over everyone that's watching, oh God, that you will open their hearts and their minds. Let them leave knowing and understanding that you are still in control and that their walk with you is so much the better. It's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. All right, tonight I won't be on that long, but I wanted to stop and give some words of encouragement. I'm going to ask if you would pray for my wife, pray for our little fella. Everything is good. They have the common cold. Amen. Not the COVID. We blessed. We don't have that. But it's just the allergies and everything else are taking a toll on them. So I won't be on that long because I'll need to go and tend to it, her and the little fella that, even though he's stuffy, he's still running around like crazy. So we solicit your prayers. And also, before we even get started, I will mention this again on Sunday, but we want to y'all lift and say thank you and give praises and say happy birthday when you get a chance. If you happen to run across her, we want to celebrate Mother Coakley. Amen. Mother Coakley celebrated a birthday of 109 years young. Amen. Amen. That is a blessing to have celebrated this birthday on this week. So we're going to acknowledge her again on Sunday, but I want to go ahead and get it out now that she celebrated a birthday this week and Mother Coakley turned 109 years old. Amen. Amen. So happy birthday to Mother Coakley. And also, we continue to pray for all of our mothers, amen, that God will continue to give them the strength that's needed to go on and to continue to be able to provide that wisdom, amen, that they have to us young folk, amen. But again, we won't be on here long. Pastor, again, has allowed me the opportunity to do a series of Welcome to a New Season, amen. We kicked that off on this past Sunday. And we're going to continue that theme a little bit throughout the next few weeks while Pastor is recovering. Amen. He was at church last Sunday, but y'all continue to pray for him. He's still recovering. But while he's recovering, he's allowed me to be able to do this series of Welcome to a New Season. And then Sunday, we talked about clearing the slate. Amen. And this Sunday, we're going to continue on in the series. So I hope that you all will tune in again on Sunday as we continue. But tonight, I just want to give a little inspiration, a little motivation, even kind of still sticking with that theme or that mindset. If I had to use a particular passage of scripture, I won't read it on tonight, but Luke chapter 9, where verses 28, and there where it starts to talk about the transfiguration of our Lord and Savior and Peter and all in that realm. What we find out is sometimes we have to reboot. Amen. Sometimes we have to reboot in where we are in life and reboot in an opportunity. As mentioned before, God has, you can take this pandemic, you can take everything else, and you can allow it to give you a negative connotation or a negative mindset about things. But what I've come to realize is that in everything, we ought to give God thanks, and in everything, we ought to give him the glory. In everything that happens, we ought to be able to receive some type of information or some type of growth of knowing that whatever situation that God has put us in, he's put us in a position to be able to overcome it. And he's given us the ability to be able to overcome it. And because of that, regardless of what happens, regardless of what state of mind that we're in, we ought to have enough sense and enough knowledge and enough faith to know that regardless of where we are, God is still going to bring us out. He's still going to deliver us. He's still going to give us and reach out his hand and pull us out of whatever it is that we're going through. So sometimes we have to look at opportunities that we have as an opportunity to stop. And again, like I said last week, stop, reset. And now we're going to talk about rebooting. A young man told me about a story of how, and he was telling the story about how he had his computer, his laptop, and his laptop was giving him some problems. It was giving him some issues because he went out and he bought this brand new software, up to date, brand new software that he was going to use, and he was going to take it and he was going to do the best he can and using it. And he took it and he started to install it on his laptop. He started to put it in and it started to run and take its course, started to upload. And then all of a sudden, everything just froze. It locked up on him. Nothing happened. No keys. Anything was moving. The screen had frozen. In the process of him uploading some new software, things had frozen on him. So he said he looked at it and he was getting frustrated. He couldn't figure out. He tried to turn it off, turn it back on. It was still. So he decided that he was going to take it to the Geek Squad. He took the computer, the laptop to the Geek Squad, and they began to do their diagnostic test on it. And he said what they found out was there's nothing wrong with the computer itself on the outside. He said what happened was it had frozen on the inside. And in that instant, in the midst of him telling that story, the first thing that came to my head, the first acknowledgement that I received was there was nothing wrong with the outer appearance. What was wrong was something on the inside. Lord, y'all catch that on y'all way home sometime tonight. That'll catch up with you. But nothing was wrong. If you look at the computer itself, it was a thing of beauty. It looked to be like it was up to date. It looked to be like it was a modern style computer. It looked to be as though it had everything going on. But on the inside, on the inside, it had frozen. And what had happened was it froze up and it wasn't performing the way it should be performing. Now, some of us ourselves, if you think about your own life, if you look in the mirror, pretty sure you probably told yourself at some point in time that you're looking good. You probably put on an outfit. You probably had your hair done. You probably bought some new clothes or whatever the case may be. And you looked in the mirror and the first thing that you said to yourself was, boy, I sure look good. Look, I'm making this suit look nice. I'm making this dress look nice. I'm making this wig look nice. I got this. Whatever it is, you at some point you looked at the mirror and you said, guess what? I got it going on. And there are so many people who have that same unfortunate misunderstanding and they fall into these traps and they fall into these snares and they realize, yeah, my outer appearance gives the impression that I have everything going on. But what people start to see and what people start to realize is on the inside, I'm messed up. On the inside, I'm frozen. On the inside, I can't progress. On the inside, I'm locked in the state that I'm in. On the inside, I need some motivation. On the inside, I'm crying. On the inside, I'm full of pain. On the inside, it's not a pretty picture. And that's unfortunately the reality that some of us have to face. Unfortunately, the reality that some of us are enduring is we give the perception on an outside appearance that we got it going on. But on the inside, there's some work that needs to be done. There's some things that need to happen. All of us have some things, if we look back over our lives and we evaluate, you might not even have to go that far. You can go back throughout the course of the day. All of us have some things that we have to look at and say, listen, Lord, fix me. Lord, help me. Lord, I need you to move in my heart and in my mind. And here we are. Here we are at a point to where we got to evaluate the inner being, the inner working that we have going on. Is it something that needs fixing? Is it something that needs a help? Is it something that needs some form of blessing? Is it something that we need to cry out to God to help us get through? I'm pretty sure it is, but somewhere we have to understand. Needed some help. He continued on with his story. He continued on telling about how he went and he took them, and they evaluated, and they said nothing's wrong with the outside. It's the inside that is frozen up. He said, what you tried to do is, watch this. He said, what you tried to do is you tried to put a new and updated software, a new and improved software into an old system, and that was not prepared to receive the system. So therefore the old stuff got mixed up with the new stuff and it caused some form of friction, and the new stuff couldn't get in and do what it was necessary because the old stuff was still in the way. It was still holding you back. It was still trying to do things of old when you try to upload a new system. You try to do things differently. You try to, and often we in our own lives, we want to do a whole lot of stuff to progress. We want to do a whole lot of stuff to move forward. We want to do a whole lot of things to get to better places in our hearts, in our minds, in our lives. But sometimes we can't get to those places. Why? Because we're too busy with the old stuff that's keeping us from moving forward. We're too busy holding on to old stuff that's outdated. We're still too busy holding on to the old things that we can't. And we can't hold on to the old things and expect to move forward, because chances are the old things that you're holding on to ain't no good. It's outdated. It needs to be replaced. It needs to move to your level. And we all guilty of it. It happens. We get comfortable. We get complacent. We get in a mindset of saying, hey, this is what I'm used to. This is what I'm comfortable. But every now and again, you'll look over and you'll see some people moving. You'll see some things progressing, and you wonder what they're doing, and you wonder how they're moving forward. It's because they're allowing themselves to be receptive to the new things that God has for them. And many of us, we miss our blessings. We miss our moving forward. We miss our advancement. Why? Because we want those things, but we don't want to be uncomfortable. We don't want to be in a position to where you're going to be uneasy. But sometimes you got to clear those things out. Sometimes you have to move some things out your heart and out your mind and out your life. And when you do that, God has some things that he's going to replace it with. He has new things. He has better things that's going to help you move forward and get to, first of all, a better relationship with him, a better communication with him. And you'll understand that, listen, if I let go and let God, there's nothing I can't do. There's nothing that I can't do if I simply let go and let God. He said, listen, yo, he said, I took it, and what they told me was it just froze. And what happened was the old stuff was still in the way. The new stuff was trying to come in. He said, all I needed to do, he said, what I needed to do was reboot my computer. He said, all we need to do is reboot it and take some things out the way and the old stuff that's outdated, that's hindering it from moving forward. He said, we just need to reboot and remove some stuff, and then your software will be able to get in there and do what's necessary for it to run, and you'll find out that once it's running, and that's where we are right now today. We're at an opportunity to reboot. We're at an opportunity to sit and allow God to come in and to remove some things that are hindering us and holding us down. But you have to be able to allow him to do it. You have to be willing to allow him to do it. You have to want to allow him to do it. It's like praying. Going down in fervent prayer, and you're praying so hard, and you're praying so mightily, and you got down there and you had a sweat, you was praying so good, only to get up from your prayer of whatever you just turned over to the Lord, and you turned and walked away and said, now how am I gonna fix this? Listen, you've done nothing but accepted the problem back. If you're going to pray and you're going to turn it over to God, I said it once, I'll continue to say it. After you prayed and you've turned it over to God, you got to get up and you got to start moving as though he's already done it. The God we serve is a God of action. He's a God of wanting to see. He wants to see your faith in action. I can't pray and ask God to bless me and advance me, and yet I'm too worried about what happened before. I'm too worried about what happened in the past. I'm too worried about last time I tried this, it didn't work out too well. Last time, we just ought to stick to what we used to, stick to what's comfortable. No, listen, if I'm going to trust God, I'm going to allow him to lead me fully. Not just a little bit. Not, oh Lord, I want you to pull me over here. I want you to lead me over here, but I don't want to step out. What would have happened and the lesson that would not have been learned had Peter not stepped out on that water? Could you imagine what would have happened and what would have happened to Jairus if he didn't listen and he didn't say when he sent him on to the house? Could you imagine? Listen, there are some things that require some faith. Rebooting requires some faith. Starting over requires some faith. Just clearing out old things. Moving, like, man, it's awesome. And again, I thought, man, ain't that how God works? Isn't that what God does? Isn't that how he functions? Listen, we can be doing certain things, and then all of a sudden when God comes in and he restores, he renews, he heals, he moves stuff and he replaces it with new, we tend to move a little bit better. And we tend to move in a sense of knowing that God is still in control. We tend to move like the devil, you have no ability, you have no power. We tend to move in a sense of so someone else can see us and ask, listen, what happened to you? And you can tell them, listen, I met a man, God told me. And then I turned everything over to him. And it's at these moments. It's at this. Opportune time that we realize and we know that God is in control. Listen, I understand that change is hard. I understand that accepting new things is difficult. I understand that it's a fearfulness and wonder and wondering and wanting to know, will it succeed? But you'll never know if you don't try. You'll never know if you don't step out on faith. You'll never know what will happen if you don't trust and try God. I challenge you to try Him. I challenge you to try God. I promise you, you'll come out on top. I promise you, you'll love everything about what's going to happen. I promise you that you'll be able to shout and you'll be able to run and you'll have a new understanding on life. It's just what happens when God intervenes. When He gets in there, He changes you from the inside. He's concerned about your heart. He's concerned about your soul. And when you allow Him to get inside your heart, your soul, your mind, and start to work on you, listen, when you go back to that mirror, when you thought you was, you thought you had dressed your outer appearance up and you thought you had it going on, listen, when you go back to that mirror and you look past what you have on and you start to think what's going on the inside, listen, there'll be a glow about you. You'll be able to say, listen, I got it going on because God is working inside of me. God is moving inside of me. That's why I know I got it going on, because it doesn't matter what's going on around me. I may not have a dime in my pocket. My car might be broke down. I may be trying to figure out where my next meal's coming from. But regardless of what's going on, because what God is doing on the inside, I can say, I still got it going on. How can I say I got it going on? Because He's working on the inside. I'm allowing Him to move on the outside, which means because of that, I realize and know that He's going to take care of me. There's nothing I'm going to go without. He's going to make sure all provisions are made. Why? Because I'm His child. I believe in Him. I trust Him. I follow Him. And because of all of that, I've decided, we all have decided, listen, I'm going to reboot. I'm going to restart. Because I'm about to go into a whole new season. I'm about to walk into a new season. I'm welcome. Listen, He said, welcome to a new season. I got some stuff for you. And when your season comes, Lord have mercy. When your season comes, understand. You realize it. You realize that God is in control. When you truly see Him, when you see Him in all His glory and all His honor and all what He's worth, there'll be a revelation. He'll reveal it to you. You look outside in the mornings. Look outside at night when you're able to look up and see stars that are so far away, but yet you can still see them shining. Think about that. When you were able to wake up, when He blew the breath of life in you one more time, He touched you with the finger of love, you ought to be able to, that's when you can see all of His power, all of His glory, and all of His honor, of everything that He's done. I get it. You can't physically see Him. He's there. The breeze that you feel going by ought to be an indication that, oh God, I feel your presence. I know you're here. I'm not saying walk around like you holier than thou. I'm not saying that everything that you do ought to be, but there ought to be just small little things that you recognize and you realize, listen, God, you exist. You are real. Just allow him to come into your heart, come into your mind, and intervene. Reboot. Change is coming. Reboot. Happiness is coming. Reboot. Gladness is coming. Reboot. Prosperity is coming. Reboot. Joy is coming. Reboot. Healing is coming. Reboot. A breakthrough is coming. Reboot the negative. Accept the positive. Block out the noise that the devil in your head. Block that out and listen to the sweet, savory voice of our Lord and Savior. And when you do that, watch the Lord go to work. Amen, amen. I told y'all I wasn't going to be on here that long, but I just wanted to share with y'all that God is in control and he's about to do some new things. He's about to restore. He's about to move. He's about to do some things that we can't simply imagine. All we have to do is just ride with him. Listen, you ever get into a car, you get nervous about somebody's driving, but you got some people you get in the car with, you just as comfortable as can be. You go to sleep, you wake up. Why? Because you know, I'm in good hands. Well, listen, let me share something with you. You in good hands with God. You ought to be able to ride comfortably, regardless of where the car is going, regardless of what road he's taking you down. Understand that he is in control. Sit back and enjoy the water. Enjoy the ride. Welcome to a new season. Because he's about to do some things in all of our lives that we can't even imagine. Amen. Amen. Listen, if you are in a situation, in a problem, just trust God. Allow him to fix it. Don't you try to fix it. You've been trying long enough and you see where that's got you. Allow him to fix it. Reboot. Let him come in and enjoy the ride. Amen. Amen. All right. Thank you all so much for tuning in. All right. There we go. I'm sorry. I lost connection for a second. But thank you all for tuning in. I hope something was said that you could take it and apply it to your everyday living. But most of all, I hope that you just truly, truly receive something from God on tonight. Listen, Sunday service, 10 a.m. We are having in-person service. All you have to do is register on the site at www.gebdallas.com. Register to attend. It's an effort to make sure we keep track of who's coming. There are seats that are still available. Please, ma'am and sirs, come out. We social distance. We have a good time and we praise the Lord together. So come out and worship with us on this coming Sunday. Continue to be in prayer for Pastor, all of our mothers and members, and also another special prayer for my wife and her mother. Her uncle is little, and we solicit your prayers for him, John Chambers. We solicit your prayers for him, as well as my wife, that's her uncle, and her mother's, Sister Mary Clark's brother. So we solicit your prayers for them. Continue to keep everyone lifted. Continue to pray for one another. And I hope, again, that something was said that you could truly have a closer walk with him. Let us pray. Eternal God, our Father, how we thank you for what our eyes have seen, our ears have heard, but most of all, God, what our hearts have felt. Now be with us, strengthen us as we go into the rest of this week. Father, whatever the desires of the hearts of those that are watching and those that are not, God, we pray that you would intervene, that you would bless, that you would reboot and restart them, God, that they could truly feel your presence. Now, God, keep us as our prayer, continue to walk with us and talk with us. And God, we just pray that you just have thine own way. Bless us continuously is our prayer in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Again, thank you all for tuning in on tonight.
All I seem to do is hurt.